The last time I came was in winter with the worship team. Amen. So I thought to come twice for me again, and if you never come to our church. And I said, remember, I came to your graduation too. Amen. I was there. You saw me. I was there. I came to your graduation, so now you can come to our church. He said, no, that's different. You have to come to our church first to preach, and I'll come. So then here I am. God is good. Remember, if you have something to ask, you have always to remember. Amen. Yeah. You know, if someone did something good to you, always remember. Hallelujah. If you remember in your life, if someone did something good to you, it's give you a heart to serve others. There are some people in this world, if you did something to them, they didn't forget. They just complain. They just crying for something. They don't even remember what you did for them. But God remember us, what we did for him. Yeah. And we have to remember what God did for us. Hallelujah. Yeah. So the salvation we receive from Jesus, we have to remember that. It's a privilege. Hallelujah. It's just by grace. What I am today and who you are today, just by grace. It's just by grace. That's why today you have a song in our life. We can sing it. We can shout. We have a peace. We have a joy because of the Lord. That's just by grace. Remember. We're going to read it. Said in the 2 Kings chapter 20, 2 Kings chapter 20, verse 1 to 6. 2 Kings chapter 20, verse 1 to 6. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
But even though you're not there, say amen. If you don't have the Bible, say amen.
Amen.
You know, I'm a teacher, I can see if you're not there, if you're there, I can see. It's 2 Kings chapter 20, verse 1 to 6. Even though you say amen, you're not there, I can see you. You don't have the Bible, I can see you're not there, but I'm going to wait for you. Amen. Hallelujah. It's good to come to church with the Bible. Amen. Don't leave your Bible at home. I know these days now we have cell phones, we have all kind of, you know, everything just about is good. Hallelujah. Chapter 20, verse 1 to 6. Who's good for in reading?
Hello.
Yes. You have the anointing for reading?
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. I like to share, you know. I cannot preach and read everything, you know. Amen. They read for us, sister. 2 Kings chapter 20, verse 1 to 6.
Second Kings chapter 20, verse 1. In those days was Hezekiah sick unto death, and the prophet Isaiah, the son of Amos, came to him and said unto him, thus saith the Lord, set thy house in order, for thou shalt die and not live. Then he turned his face to the wall and prayed unto the Lord, saying, I beseech thee, O Lord, remember now how I have walked before thee in truth and with a perfect heart, and have done that which is good in thy sight. And Hezekiah wept sore. And it came to pass, before Isaiah was gone out into the middle court, that the word of the Lord came to him, saying, turn again, and tell Hezekiah, the captain of my people, thus saith the Lord, the God of David thy father, I have heard thy prayer, I have seen thy tears. Behold, I will heal thee. On the third day, thou shalt go up unto the house of the Lord. And I will add unto thy days 15 years.
Wow.
And I will deliver thee and this city out of the hand of the king of Assyria. And I will defend this city for my own sake and for my servant David's sake.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The Bible says King Hezekiah was the greatest king in the history of Judah. And the name Hezekiah is in Hebrew, means God is my strength. Amen.
Amen.
God is my strength. If you're looking for a name, you're going to call your son. If you call Hezekiah, it means God is my strength.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, sometimes those coming from Africa, we have some names, they don't mean anything. Amen. This is our culture. You know, if your mom, your dad, you are born in a bad situation, they call some names, bad names. I don't even encounter the habit, but it's normal. Because they didn't have anything to say about you, they call bad names. But if you call your son Hezekiah, it means God is my strength.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So when you call our son, our daughter's name, we have to understand the meaning before we call those names. Because our parents, long time ago, they didn't know. They call you according to the situation they live in. So if they're in a situation of poor, they're going to call poor. If they don't have nothing to eat, they're going to call you anything they can call. But God is good. We have names in the Bible. So I'm a teacher in the Bible. I say the names we have in the Bible, they are good names. I saw this son called Asher. But the name of that son, that boy. Okay, so I actually told you the name. My second boy's name is Asher. So we took that from the Bible. So I thought it's the name. It's a great name. So when we call our children good names, there's a meaning behind.
Amen.
Make sure you call your son or your daughter a good name. There's a meaning. So if you call Hezekiah, it means God is my strength.
Amen.
Amen. Because the name you have will go always with you.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why I say in my creation, I don't read my names. Some of them, they call my name is too long. Say, yeah, my friend did it by purpose to make it difficult. Hallelujah. But there's a meaning behind. The meaning is good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If the Bible tells those days, the king Hezekiah became very sick. He was very sick and was ready to die. Hallelujah. Because these days, you know, when you are sick, you know one day you're going to die. Mm. Today I'm not sick. I don't think about the dead. But when you are sick, you know you can count your days. But those days, the Bible said, Hezekiah, the king Hezekiah, was really, really sick. And the prophet Isaiah just brought the news to him to say, you know what? We know you're sick, but you're going to die soon. You are sick. I know it's the end of your life. You know, sometimes in life you don't like to hear the bad news. You know, you wake up in the morning, go to the office, they tell you today is your last day. It's not a good news. Buying a mortgage on Saturday and the Monday is the last day. It's not a good news. You know, brother and sister, be ready to receive any news in your life. Any news you receive in your life, the good thing, you have a God in your life.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Doesn't matter the news you're going to receive, but if you have a God in your life, God can change your situation.
Amen.
Hezekiah in the Bible was a great man, was a man of integrity, was a man of serving the Lord, but he became sick. But when you get the news from the prophet Isaiah, and that news was coming from God, it's not from Isaiah, because God tell him that he's going to die soon. But what he have to do is just to see what he have. You know, in our culture in Africa, if you are rich and they know you are going to die, you have to take what you have and share among your children, just to be able to know, if you are not there, I'll be fair with my family. You know, each one receive his part. He said, go, this is time to prepare yourself. Take what you have and share between your wife and children to make sure by the time you're going to die, your life will be end and there's no any problem at the end. But the man of God, when he heard the news, he knows what to turn. Hallelujah. You know, sometimes you hear the bad news in your life, you try to find who can give the solution. Hallelujah. Sometimes you go to the wrong people. When the bad news comes to you, the first idea is, you know what, I have to run after the pastor. I have to run after my sister. I have to run after my parents. I have to run after this. But you know, the king Hezekiah, he knew where to turn.
Amen.
He turned to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. For sure, he had the opportunity to talk to his wife. to children, to other members of the government, all these people beside him, but he knew the answer comes from God. I don't know what you tell today when you come, when you get bad news. We are human beings, you know. Sometimes you don't know what to do in a tough situation. You cry in your room. You try to find a way to find a solution. But the Bible says, when they hear bad news, he turned his face to the wall and he prayed. Hallelujah. You know, when you pray, you touch the heart of God. When you pray, you show that you have a faith in your life. Hallelujah. Amen. Before you tell anybody your problem, you turn to God. Because Ezekiah, he knew, the Bible said, in that time he was only 39. He was on the throne for almost 14 years. So you know, dying at 39 is not fair. Because at 39, when you reach 40, that's the age you start to enjoy life. That's the age you start to see your plan be realized. So at 39, you get a news that you're going to die. He said, no, I have to live. Amen. Amen. I refuse, I have to live.
Amen.
I refuse, I have to live. I have to live. Because Ezekiah knew he has a future. You see children, see family, see wives. No, I have to live. It's not my time to die. Even though I'm sick, I know God, you can heal me.
Amen. Amen.
Even though the news comes from you, that news can be changed.
Amen.
Because it's a hope. Yeah. Hallelujah. Then he prayed. He said, God, I know, I remember that you're God. You're my God. You know, in our prayer, you have to have the confidence what you're praying for. Amen.
Yeah.
You know, prayer is not just multiplication of word. It's not imitate what other person praying. There's one of my students I was teaching this year on the phone, because we started on the phone. There's a man of God, he's from Burundi. When he's praying on the phone, you feel the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
So his prayer, when he's praying, every time I was given to pray, other students, they were always intimidated. So this one asked me, Pastor, this man, how get that prayer? The way he talk, the way he used the Bible, the way he used the word is very strong to me. I said, don't worry, don't be intimidated. Pray God with your word. Amen. Don't try to imitate someone else.
Yes.
Be yourself.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't try to impress anybody. God is God who knows what you need.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Yes. You see, those of us who are parents, you know, children, when they come to you, they know which word to use to ask when they want to ask you. Amen. If you have three, they come in different ways. Then some of them come to you, they just laugh in front of you, you know they need something. Hallelujah. Then some of them, they know how to lie to you to get what they want. Then some of them, they're honest. They say, Daddy, you know, I want this. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, I have a son as well. When he needs something, he knows how to catch me. He knows I'm a man of plan. You cannot tell him to buy something tomorrow for you. But if he needs something in 2 months, he's going to tell me 3 months before. And for sure I'm going to buy it, because he knows I need to plan on my budget. So, because he knows how to, and I end up buying it. And whatever I need, I'll buy it. Because he gives me some time. Hallelujah. So when you come to God, use your prayer. Be yourself. Amen.
Yes.
Ezekiah, he knows that he's in a bad situation. He said, God, I don't want to die. But even though I don't want to die, I know you can give me life to begin to live.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
When you pray, have faith. When you pray, that you know that you're talking to God. You're not talking to your pastor. You're talking to God, who has the key for your life.
Yes.
Ezekiel knows it. Now is my time when I'm going to die. Let me ask you a question. Dying and losing a job, which one is easy?
Dying, of course.
Dying?
Of course.
Yeah, of course. Now, if you know you're going to die, you're going to die. But if you lose a job, you're going to find another job after tomorrow.
Yeah, exactly. Amen.
Yeah, if you find me tomorrow, not Tuesday, you're going to find another one. It's not a problem. But if I'm dying, I'm not going to enjoy life again.
That's it.
So, he knows the message comes from Isaiah. Whatever you're doing, Ezekiah, you're dying. Amen.
Yeah.
You know, in life, you get news everywhere. Sometimes the bad news comes from yourself, in your mind. Amen. You know, you're sitting in your room, you see what you're going through in your life, you see how bad life is, what you're going through, and you're thinking, you say, what I'm going through. And yourself, you feel the bad thought, With yourself, you feel bad with the bad ideas, you know. You end up killing yourself because you don't have hope. Amen.
Yeah.
I tell people always in my church, I love myself, I cannot kill myself. Whatever can happen in my life, I cannot kill myself because I like to enjoy life.
Amen.
I like to enjoy life. When I reached 40s a few years ago, I'm not young in the way you think. I'm not old too. When I reached 40, I say, God, give me more years to live. Amen.
Amen.
More, I want to enjoy life. Life is good. That's the company I'm working for, by the way. I'm working for LG Electronics. So, to live is good. I want to live. I don't want to die. Whatever is going to happen in my life, I want to live. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They say, no, I'm 39 only. I want to live.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Take your mind, say, God, today I want to live.
I want to live.
Whatever is happening in my life, I want to live.
I want to live.
I lost my job, I want to live.
I want to live.
I'm sick today, but I want to live.
I want to live.
Three more years to live.
I want to
Hallelujah.
Live.
Hallelujah. And that's why I think God answers my prayer. I'm still looking young. People, they call me, I'm 25, you have 32. I say, thank you. I'm more than that. But God is good. Ezekiel, he prayed because he believed. But what we're going to touch today is what he used in prayer. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Time to enjoy life. Say, God, no, I don't want to die. But even though I don't want to die, I came to you. It's time to make a deal. Hallelujah. Our God is a God of deal.
Yes.
Amen. The same way we deal with our children, God deals with us that way. When you talk to your God, take your God as a father.
Amen.
Hallelujah. When you go to your room, when you pray, be honest in front of God.
Amen.
The Bible says, even before we pray, God knows what we want.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Before even you open your mouth, God knows what you want. So it's better to be honest. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
If you need something, say, God, I need this thing so bad. Help me to get it. It's your dream. So pray about it. When it's come on the deal in the will of God, you receive it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's a higher pray because you need life. But I like him because he don't touch the heart of God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
I was thinking about children. You know, every children knows how to cut a parent. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Every children know how to catch a parent. They know how to cut a parent. They know how to touch the heart of the parent because they know that the parent is there for them. And our God is there for us.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Then when he started to pray, he said three things. The first one, he said, I have walked before you faithfully. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I have walked before you faithfully. That means whatever I was doing in my life, you saw that I'm a great man in front of you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't know if today you can stand up in front of people and say, God, the life I've been living, I'm faithful to you.
Amen.
If you can do that, go ahead. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Second thing said, with all heart devotion. You see, whatever I was doing, my heart was to you, God.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Remember, oh Lord, remember. Remember what I've been doing for you. So today, when I'm in a bad situation, or I'm having a hard time, I say, God, remember all those times I've been traveling, teaching about Bible study.
Amen.
I mean, sometimes I'm so tired and find myself in Nairobi, find some days in a village somewhere, I don't know. There's certain place I don't even know. When I went to in Uganda, the place called Angora, I didn't know that place. But you have to see me traveling from Kigali to Kampala in a bus during the night. You know, I left Kigali at 5 o'clock and I reached Kampala 4 a.m. in the morning. So for me, say, God, I was sitting in the bus, saying, what am I doing in this bus? With the people just, you know, the noise in Africa in the bus. You know those buses from Kigali, yeah. Kampala. So many people, there many thieves in the bus. I said, God, what am I doing in this bus? I left my wife and my children in Canada. Now I'm sitting in the bus going to Kampala. I don't know if anyone is in Kampala, by the way. I was asking, what time are you going to leave me in Kampala? I said, God, remember those days. Amen.
Amen.
Remember those days. When I reached Kampala, I just teach the Bible study. And God, they are blessed. Amen.
Amen.
So, he said, I'll say, you know what, remember, oh Lord. And the third thing, he said, I have done what is good in your eyes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You know, when you go to God, have something to say.
Yes.
Amen. Have something to say in front of God.
Yes.
What do you have to say today? What do you have to say in front of God?
My God.
Amen. You know, the prayer is yours. Have a prayer, original prayer, come from your heart. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't pray my prayer. Mine is mine. The same way we have a different DNA. So I have my prayer and you have yours. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. My need and not your need. Hallelujah. Yeah. What I need in front of me is not what you need. So when you pray, be yourself. Amen. Amen. You know, these days, some people they say, oh, you know, we have 25, 21 days of prayer. The others, they come up with 40s. The others, they had now, they come with 70. Now it's come 80, now come 120s. So even with stage one, then keep the quality of prayer.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah. Don't be intimidated with numbers. No. Let the numbers for those people. Yeah. Just keep one, yeah. The best one for God. Yeah. Amen. Be yourself.
Amen.
Because God created you unique. I'm unique. You cannot be me. I cannot be you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why if you try to get my anointing, it's not possible because God created me, give me that anointing.
Amen.
If you want to be a teacher, if God gives to you, praise God, but you will not be a teacher like me. So because what I'm doing what God gave to me.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
There's so many people they try to sing, the people they try to play keyboard. If you buy a keyboard, you can't even touch it. It's not for them. Hallelujah. It's not for them. You know, be yourself. The only thing I know in life, God is fair.
Amen.
Amen. Anything God gave to you, I know maybe I'm talking to some people. Amen.
Amen.
If I'm talking about you, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You know, God gives you something unique in you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I feel I can sit with anybody, I can say, you know what? You're unique in front of God.
Amen.
Amen. Don't try to follow an anointing for another person. What you have in your heart, it's unique.
Amen.
Amen. And it's valuable in the kingdom of God. Amen. Anything you have, even sitting there and be quiet, it's a blessing.
Yes.
Amen. There's some people they cannot be quiet. There's some people they have anything to talk. They like to talk. But there's others they can be quiet. Amen. When others people they are talking, they are quiet. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. God is good. Be yourself in front of God. Because we came these days in a situation people they try to be like others.
Yes.
Amen. If I cannot sing like that person, I'm not good. No, your song is unique.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you sing in your room, when you sit down somewhere singing, God hear your heart.
Amen.
It's gone. Amen. It's a cryer. He said, God, look what I went through.
Yes.
I have done what is good in your eyes. Because you remember what you went through. I try to fight as much as I can for your glory. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God will never forget what you did in your life.
Amen.
For me, I can forget you, or you can forget me, but God will never forget you.
Amen.
Every single thing you're doing in your life is very important in the eyes of God.
Amen.
Amen. Everything you have done in your life is very important in the eyes of God. If you're doing that for the glory of God, God will take it seriously.
Amen.
So that's why you can say, God, remember. Remember, oh Lord, today when I go to your room, have that prayer. Say, Jesus, remember. Remember the night I was praying. Remember the night I was going in the winter time, going outside serving the food. Amen.
Yeah.
Have something to sell in front of God. Remember, God, that day I take my money to go to help someone. You know, have something in your life. If you don't have anything, try to find it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Maybe you are lazy, you are sitting there, don't know anything. So if you don't have anything, do something.
Exactly.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why I try to put the best I can. Because the vision we have, the ministry is just came from Cairo to South Africa, to reach the whole continent. Amen. How? I don't know. By faith, it's possible.
Amen.
Amen. Because we need to do something for the Lord. So as a cast of God, I have done many things for you. My Lord, my heart was for you. I did good things for your glory. Amen.
Yes.
You know, there are some people, they have a ministry in silence. They don't say anything.
Yes.
By the time we leave here, they just go to meet someone. Amen. They serve the food.
Yeah.
They have whatever they have. They don't say anything. But those moments, remember, share with God when you pray.
Amen.
Say, God, remember that moment I have. Remember that what I did for that person.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the God we serve, it's a God of action.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. It's a God of action. You know, when we tell God something, He will do something. Hallelujah. You know, the principle for my life, before I borrow money somebody, I have to make sure you're going to give to me. Amen. Because you know, in my life, I don't like to tell someone who cannot do anything for me. Amen. If I know you pray and say, pray for me, because I know you're going to pray. Amen. I don't tell you to pray for me if I know you don't pray for me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If I know you have money, but you don't share your money, I don't have to borrow it. You never give it to me. Why I have to tell you? Because I will tell you, you know that you don't give to me and you have for me for nothing. Amen. So I have to target someone, say, if I tell Sister Immaculate to give me some money, and she has money, she will give to me. So first of all, I have to know, first of all, if you have money, second, you can give to me. Because if you don't have money, you have a good heart. There's no point to tell you to give money. But if you have money and you have a good heart, so those two things you're going to give to me at the end.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So God, when you approach God, whatever you say will do it for your glory.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Is it God who provides? Is God who hears your prayer?
No.
Hallelujah. You know, sometimes you can tell someone your problems. Instead of receiving a prayer for it, he became another problem for other people. Hallelujah. Instead of take that problem to, you know, if you take a children, say, you know what, I give this, don't tell it to your brother. You're going to just tell, you know what, that gave to me this, but I tell you, don't tell you. Now, it takes mature people. When someone brings a request to you for prayer, just for you.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's not something you're going to share. Because, you know, there's a lot we share in prayer. You know, if I say, Michael, I have a problem, just I give to you, pray for me. Just don't go home with your girl, say, you know what, let's pray for Bonaventure has a problem. No, that's no prayer. Because now you share my problem to others. And I didn't allow you to do that. You know, we need to be wise, smart, to know how to deal with people. Hallelujah. Hezekiah, sister, she's laughing. Am I talking about you? Amen. God is good. God is good. Hezekiah, when he hear about that, he prayed. He just turned his face to the Lord. Amen. He turned his face to the Lord because he knows where the strength comes. Amen. You have to know where to target. You have to know where to go. You have to know which people to reach. You know which people to visit. You know which way can help you. You know this body cannot help you. Hallelujah. You know how to choose friends. Hallelujah. God give us wisdom to choose the right friends.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Because bad friends sometimes they don't help you in life.
Mm-mm.
Hallelujah. But if you have a good friend, they will help you. They will lift you up. They're going to bring you far in your life. Ezekiel knows, I have God. So in this situation, even before I share with my wife or my children, let me go to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Before I start to make noise on the throne, let me go to God.
Amen.
Because he has the one has the final answer. Because even the message came from the prophet Isaiah, it came from God.
Amen.
So because God says something, he is able to change it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Whatever you hear from other people in your life, God can change it.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, in our culture, in Africa, you know, when I say our culture, Africa is the same.
Yes.
If I went in Uganda, I felt whatever they are doing is the same what I saw when I grew up. When I was in Nairobi, what I saw in Nairobi, what I saw in Burundi, the same. Our continent is the same. I don't know those Arab countries in the north, but other countries is the same. So, you know, long time ago, I used to see parents, they try to curse their children. They said, you know what? In your life, nothing will happen to your life. You'll be a bad person. So a parent tell the children, you know, let me tell you something. Even though our children, God give us for some time to raise them. Amen. It's only God who knows the future. Amen. Maybe they curse you. Maybe they told you a bad word. Maybe someone is trying to tell you never do anything in your life. But tell me, let me tell you something. God is able to change that.
Amen.
I hope it's not only in Africa. Everywhere.
Amen.
People, they can see you. They try to underestimate you.
Yes.
They say, you know what? You didn't have a chance to go to school. You're never doing anything in your life. Let me tell you something. School is good. But some people, they want to school. They don't know anything about life.
Right.
Amen.
Sure.
Maybe your wife tell you, you know what? You never do anything in your life. Or maybe your husband. But today I have a good news for you.
Amen.
You have a God.
Amen.
God can change your life.
Yes.
God can change whatever they told you.
Change my life.
Whatever you're coming from, God can change your life.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because we live in the world where people, the prophet Isaiah, say, you know, God said, you're not dying, you're meant to live. It's about good news. God is good. When God answers to you, He gives you a bonus. Hallelujah. If you read your Bible, God said, you know, you're not dying. Now, you're going to live. Now I give you for 15 years more years to live.
Hey!
Hallelujah.
My God.
To live. I want to live more years. I want to enjoy life. Amen. I wish you to live too.
Amen.
Never say, oh, life is too hard, I want to die. No, that's why it's not my prayer. Life is too good to live. Amen.
Amen.
Let me enjoy it. Enjoy life.
Goodness,
God said, I'm going to give you 15 more years to live. If you're supposed to die today, take another 15 years to enjoy. Amen. Take 15 years to enjoy life because you deserve it. You remind me what you did for me. You show me your heart. Hallelujah. Because if you touch my heart, I'm really concerned about your life.
Yes.
Amen. Brother and sister, they touch the heart of God. Amen. These people can touch the heart of God. And if you don't know how to touch the heart of God, read the Bible. Amen. What God wants from you and from me is just to have good eyes to look at God and say, God, today I need you to transform my life. Amen. I need to see my life be transformed by word. I want to be a person who want me to be.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you see your life transform every day. And you'll be like the way God wants you to be. Hallelujah.
Yeah. Wow.
Amen.
Amen.
The first thing he said to Isaiah, I will heal you. Amen.
Amen.
Jump. Because you are sick now, you'll be healed. Hallelujah. You know, when you are sick, that's where you understand how to pray for the doctors. Amen. How many people pray for doctors? Until you're sick. God bless you, Mama. You know, when you are sick really on the bed, that's where you understand how God is praying for them. Amen.
Amen.
And you start to pray in tongues because you pray for them.
Amen.
When you are healed, you forget about them. But God is good. God knows that we are human beings. You know? And second, He said, on the third day from now, you will go up to the temple of the Lord.
Wow.
Hallelujah. God, when did God give you a favor, it doesn't care where you're coming from. Amen.
Yeah.
You know, there's some places we are born. You can even tell the name, you go there, shake them up, you can't even see them. Amen. But when God gives you a favor, He just lifts you up. Hallelujah. And when He lifts you up, when God lifts you up, it doesn't care where you're coming from. Because when the favor of God is upon you, you are blessed.
Amen.
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 Third thing. I'll add 15 years to your life. That means 15 years in your life, it's a bonus. If you're supposed to, die at 50, then you're going to die to 65.
Wow.
Hallelujah. 15 years more to live. Amen.
Amen.
The fourth thing, I will deliver you in this city from the hand of king of Assyria.
Wow.
You're supposed to be defeated, but you're going to leave now because I hear your prayer and your cry. I saw your heart. And the last thing, I will defend this city for my sake and for the sake of my servant David. Because God, when He tried to save you, He go far in your generation in your life. Amen. You're going to touch your uncle somewhere. You're going to touch your aunt somewhere. You're going to touch your dad, your mom, your family, everybody because of your favor. Hallelujah. That's why you're sitting here singing, and next day you get the news, oh, my sister has been saved somewhere in Africa. It's because of the favor of God.
Amen.
Amen. Because when you're in a place like this, we attract the anointing from God.
Amen.
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 Brother and sister, this place, take it seriously.
Amen.
Amen. This is not the factory. This is the place where we receive anointing from God.
Amen.
Amen. This is the place God dwell. When God is here, He's serious with you.
Amen.
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 Whatever you take from my mama, your mama, God take it seriously.
Amen.
Whatever you say to God, take it seriously.
Yes.
God will answer your prayer.
Amen.
I came today to tell you that God will do something today in your life.
Amen. I receive it.
Maybe you have been struggling.
Call this petition, Lord.
You're in the right place. You have been going through any problem, but I have a good news for you. We have a God. We have a God who can change the situation. We have a God who can change your life. I have a good news for you. You are special in the eyes of God. Amen. You are special. You are unique. Amen. Whatever you're going through, you are unique. That's where it resides my joy, because I'm unique. You cannot change me, because I know I have a God who is unique. Amen. Whatever we went through, maybe you lose your job, you lose your family, you went through many problems, you don't know what to do, you don't know what direction to take, but God is with you.
Amen.
Today, God will give you another chance to say, God, I want to receive it. Because it's a God who can change.
Amen.
I'm going to just finish with our sister, she's doing good. Just read for us at Acts chapter 9. 35 to 43, then I'll finish with that, then we're going to pray. Amen.
Yeah.
The worship team will be ready to prepare for a nice song, and then we're gonna just go through prayer. Acts chapter 9, 35 to 43. If you find it, please say amen. It's an easy book, it's a New Testament. Acts chapter 9, 35 to 43.
Chapter 9, verse 35. And all that dwelt at Lydda and Saron saw him and turned to the Lord. Now there was at Joppa a certain disciple named Tabitha, which by interpretation is called Dorcas. This woman was full of good works and alms deeds, which she did. And it came to pass in those days that she was sick and died, whom when they had washed, they laid her in an upper chamber. And forasmuch as Lydda was nigh to Joppa, and the disciples had heard that Peter was there, they sent unto him two men, desiring him that he would not delay to come to them. Then Peter arose and went with them. When he was come, they brought him into the upper chamber, and all the widows stood by him weeping and showing the coats and garments which Dorcas made while she was with them. But Peter put them all forth and kneeled down and prayed, and turning him to the body said, Tabitha, arise. And she opened her eyes, and when she saw Peter, she sat up, and he gave her his hand and lifted her up. And when he had called the saints and widows, presented her alive. And it was known throughout all Joppa, and many believed in the Lord. And it came to pass that he tarried many days in Joppa with one Simon a tent.
Amen. Praise God. If you have a time, just go home and read and meditate the word of God. I was trying just to take Hezekiah and Tabitha, because if a good preacher, I have to take a man and a woman. Amen. To be fair. He's a God of man and woman. Amen. I cannot preach only on Hezekiah without preaching Tabitha. I mean, because the anointing from Hezekiah is for men and Tabitha is for women. But God answered the prayer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. God is good.
All the time.
And this time was really a hard time for these widows, as the Bible said. Did the Bible say Tabitha was dead? Was finished. You know, the history was done. Nothing to do anymore. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It was done. It was not like being sick. Because if you are sick, they can pray for you. And you come to, you are healed. But Tabitha was dead. But these widows, they recognized what Tabitha did for them. Hallelujah. What did you do in your life? what you can leave legacy in your life. Then don't say about houses or cars, that's for you. What did you do for others? You know, someone said in life, what is important in life is not what you did for yourself, it's what you did for others.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. What you did for others is very more than you did for you.
Yeah.
Because if I'm doing something for myself, it's my comfort for myself. But if I did it for you, I touch your heart.
Yes.
You have the power, the day I'll be there. You say, you know what, this man has to be alive. Amen. Because he don't supposed to die now, it's not the right time. Because Tabitha did a lot for many people. And she was silent. She didn't say anything. She was acting. And these widows, when they came, said, no, it's not that. Peter, we know this woman not supposed to die. We still need her. Amen.
Amen.
Not supposed to die. And Peter, when they came, said, if he said she's not supposed to die, what she did in life? What do you have to say? And they started to bring stories. She used to bring clothes. She used to, whatever she did, they have a list. Hallelujah. And Peter, if you read the Bible, he cried. When he prayed and he cried. The power of prayer and crying. Amen. When you cry, when you pray and start to cry, don't think you backslide. It's normal. You touch the heart of God. Amen. Or if you see someone crying, say, this woman is crying too much, or this man is crying too much. No, let them cry. Amen.
Amen.
You don't know why someone's crying. You know? You don't know. Really. We can be in the church. Some people, they're crying because they have a joy. Some people, they're crying because of what they're going through in their life. Some of them, they cry because they don't need to go home and my friend, my bills waiting for me. Let them cry. Amen.
Amen.
God is the one who can judge. Amen.
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 Cry. If you want to cry, cry. Because when you cry, you show it coming from your heart. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says Peter, he took this woman very seriously. If they bring that request to me to bring Tabitha life, it's because she deserves it. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
She deserves to live again. I'm going to bring back her in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Then everybody put together, say, we're going to pray Tabitha come back.
Amen.
This storm is the Bible. Tabitha, she gave in life.
Wow.
Amen. To continue, she starts in life. Amen. God has something to do in our life.
Yes.
Amen.
Maybe now you feel like you're Tabitha, you're dead. You can be here. But you feel like in your life you are nothing. Amen. In your mind, you feel like you are nothing. You just come to find a refuge in the church. But by the time you leave here and go home, you continue to cry. Brother and sister, today I have to stop to cry for this thing. You have to have a cry for joy.
Hallelujah.
God is going to change it. When you wake up in the morning, say, God, I thank you because I'm crying because I have the joy. Hallelujah. Last Sunday was Father's Day. That's the day I saw I really cried seriously. I was writing to me a message he sent to me for the Father's Day. It was very strong to me. I said, how do you think about these things? And I asked him, why do you write to me these things? You know, Daddy, I love you and I appreciate what I've been done to you.
Wow.
You know? I said, you know, I wake up in the morning, I think about you. I say, I have to make you happy. Amen.
Wow.
But you know what? He has planned something. After a few days, you know what? I have some shoes I'm working for you to buy it for me. I said, I'll buy it for you, my dear. Amen. Amen. We have something to say and to give.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. He's very smart boy. He knows. You know, when you come to God, have something to God.
Yeah.
Amen. It's your right.
Yeah.
You know, if you have some sister or brother, say, God, remember one day I was working in the winter time, I visited someone and helped. It's your right. Don't tell anybody, just tell God.
Amen.
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 You know, the bad thing is just to help someone, to tell someone that I don't have. No, if they give to you, I have to say, God, remember those days when I was in Kampala in the night, in the bus, struggling, I don't know if I'm going. Eh?
Yes.
You know, but those days, I have something to say.
Yes.
You know, what we have today in Tabitha, she can have life. Amen. Ezekiah, get a life. And today, we can have life.
Amen.
We have a God who answers. To have God who can listen to your prayer and say, today, I'm not just listening, I'm acting.
Amen.
Amen. There's two different things. You can tell me your problem and I say, you know what, I'm listening, but I don't really. Amen. But when you tell me your problem and I'm acting, I help you. Amen.
Yes.
When someone says, oh, you know what, brother, sister, I'm hungry, don't tell me you're going to pray for me. I need the food. Then pray after. Amen. Amen. Just make a difference. When I ask you, pray a prayer for me. When I need something, you know, don't be too much spiritual. It's a real. Because your prayer, they cannot feed me, but I need food. Give me food and pray for me after. Amen. Yeah, be practical. That's how God acts. Amen. If someone tells a problem, do something. If you can do it. Hallelujah. It's not because I underestimate prayer, it's very important. But sometimes we go far to become too much spiritual. Instead of resolve a situation, we just go through prayer. It's good, but do something and pray. It's going to be more efficient. Hallelujah. Unless if you don't have anything. But if you have it, you don't have money account, someone say, I'm hungry, just feed a person and pray.
Amen. Amen.
And that prayer is going to be very powerful.
Yes.
But if you just only pray, that person will not receive the prayer. But God is good. It was our heart.
Amen.
That's going to be another teaching for another day if you invite me. Amen. God is good. We're going to stand up in prayer together. Amen. I'm going to ask the worship team to come to the front. I'm going to ask you a special song. So I know worship is already prepared.